Okay, let's start the speech. My topic is road accident. Road accident is something very common, something we always hear it every day. But do you think it's so common? According to me, no. According to you, I really don't know. But what are the things what we think actually about the road accidents? It's a kind of very common thing which we see in our daily schedule. But is it? According to me, no. Because at that time we see someone die. At that time we see someone who is injured. And you know the bad and the worst part? No one even able to come to help them. They are standing there, people. They means people. People are standing there and they are just watching like there is something movies going on. Is it so? Is it so? Is it so entertainment for them? I don't think so, no. And if at the same time, if our family members are standing there and our relatives are lying there and they met an accident at that time, we say, oh my God, our relatives, we want to save them. Oh, please come, help us. Is it so? There is a difference actually. When we see our family members, our known person, at that time we want to help them. But when we see unknown people, then at that time we say, oh gosh, please someone come and help them. Oh, but what about you, yeah? Why don't you help them? What's happened with you? You can also do that thing which you are expecting from the others. Now, for road accidents, we actually blame to our government, our politics, our politicians. Is it so? Are they driving? Are they driving the car? Are they breaking the rules? I don't think so, no. Actually, we ourselves responsible for the road accidents. Yes, what are the factors basically behind the road accidents? There are so many factors, and the most funny thing, we are responsible for those road accidents. First of all, we are always in a hurry. I don't really don't know. I never understand that why Indians are always in a hurry. Even they always reach late. We can take today's example also. Everyone were almost late. Everyone reached around at 11:30 and the time was 10:45. Still, they want to break their rules. They don't want to follow traffic rules. Second, they want to drive after having liquor. Is it so? Is it so good that having the liquor and then you are driving? Ravi Rajan, I'm talking to you also about this. So please, if you are expecting something from your government, then first of all, follow those rule regulations which government has made for you. Government is for protecting us. Not government is driver. Not government will drive the car instead of you. So whatever rules regulation government had made, that made for you so that you can follow them. So before blaming government, before blaming other person, just check yourself. Are you following those traffic rule regulations? Are you actually not drunk at the time of driving? So now a part of this, let's talk about the humanity. What happened to our humanity? We are in India and we Indians are so famous for relations, related, humanity, always ready to help each other, but really we do. I don't think so, no. And I would like to say one thing. Road accidents was happening in metro cities earlier, many years ago now. It is like a disease which is spreading all over in the world, and day by day in small towns also road accidents happen so fast that it's become like a fast furious movie actually. So it's a kind of that disease for which we don't need any doctor, we don't need any medicine. And see, we are expecting and for the next person that person will come and that person will stop that road accident. But is it so? We don't need to wait for anyone else. We ourselves will stop this. But for that, first of all, we have to promise ourselves that yes, we will follow the traffic rules. Yes, we will never drunk while driving. And yes, we will first of all keep patience. Patience is the first thing which you guys need, and not you guys, we all need. Right? And you know what? If you are with your friends, you see your friend is driving very fast, very rash driving or something. If that person is drunk, you should stop him or her and advise them, because when you will start, automatically that person will start stopping the other guys. So guys, please make sure while road accident, first of all, always help. And today there is a new law made by the government that if you will help someone, cops will not disturb you, cops will not ask you, cops will not call you in police station. They will come to you, they will ask you whatever they want to ask. But please guys, whenever you see any accident, just go and help them. That God is giving you an opportunity to help someone, and those who are getting this opportunity, they are actually lucky to do something good for someone else. And I'm telling you, it's a kind of giving a birth to the someone. And you know, this is the one example that even man can give the birth. Yes. Man can give the birth, man can save the life of someone, and there's a second birth of that person. So guys, never lose such kind of opportunity. This is a golden time to save someone's life and to have blessings from so many people. So I hope I would like to conclude this speech that yes, we will help each other at the time of accident, and I wish no one will meet this accident. Thank you.